service, press 2. All agents are busy right now. You were caller 7,862. Your estimated hold time is 3 days. For your listening pleasure, please enjoy the reading of War and Peace. And have a nice few days.
Good morning, everyone. I have some news for you. I do not have a farm. I do not have any pigs. And as far as I know, my partner Farshid doesn't have any farms or pigs either.
No.
Our simple mission in life is to tackle that evil experience. Calling a company, whether you want to buy something or get service for something, is unnecessarily painful, both for the business and for the caller. This is a problem that is dying to be solved. We think we have the right approach. And we also think that this is really where consumer and enterprise technology meets. So without any further ado, I'd like to show you what we've been working on. Can we see the Elmo cam, please? So imagine, if you will, that our application is a part of Farshid's insurance company's iPhone app. The first thing that we do is completely rethink the idea of finding the person that you need to speak with. Don't press 1, press 3. Navigate to the next menu, press 4, press 5, and go through that whole process. Simply search. It's something that we're all familiar with. Type in exactly what you want. He hurt his back. He needs an acupuncturist, a referral. Types in what he wants, and he finds the selection. In this case, his insurance company would like some additional information to pinpoint exactly where that call should go. So he also enters in his group ID number. Next, what happens is that the call is actually registered into the agent's phone system, and that's what you're hearing right there. So it actually goes into the queue, and a message pops back telling him exactly where he is in the queue. Now, up until now, what I've shown you is kind of referred to as callback or deep dialing. It's not really revolutionary other than the search part of it. But what happens next is pretty interesting. So the agent then decides to call Farshid up on his phone, and when he does so, the power of data and voice together really becomes meaningful. So when this call gets initiated, it turns out that the insurance company actually has a promotion for flu shots, okay? So rather than just make a call, while he's speaking to Farshid, he actually pushes the coupon, the promotion, to his iPhone. Now at that point, using other people's services, we can take advantage of check-in, location, and a number of other technologies and really make that promotion come to life as well. Furthermore, rather than just send you an address, which is meaningless because an address is going to be somewhere buried in your emails that you're going to have to dig up later on, why not send a Google map? Here too, the phone takes over and we use all the rich capabilities of the phone, so Farshid, who gets lost often, can actually use the phone and its directions and all the native capabilities and get turn-by-turn directions. Now, that's impressive, that's interesting, but it turns out, like many of the entrepreneurs who are launching here, we've been very busy and we forgot to pay some of our bills. So, I don't know if this has ever happened to you guys. I know that most of the women, especially my wife, they're much better drivers, much more careful. I'm placing an order while I'm driving and they ask me for my credit card. And then I'm digging through trying to find my credit card number, or you're in a public place and you have to read out all that information. In this case, the agent just sends a payment option to his screen. So again, he can process that payment and be done with it and move on. Now, as impressive as all of that is, when you use a smartphone from time to time, and I'm not naming names, you're going to have a dropped call. And how does that feel after you spend 20 minutes explaining your situation and the call just dies? In this case, let's see what happens. So Farshid disconnects the call. The insurance company has a policy. They actually want to be able to hold that pipe open for about a minute, so he reconnects. As he reconnects, what's interesting is that he can reconnect with that same agent, but let's say it's a different agent. The entire history of what was corresponded, all the transactions back and forth, are right there. So he can immediately get back to speed to where he needs to be. This is something the business wants and the caller. They both want a shorter call, but they do want to speak to each other, okay? Now, not all calls are made from smartphones, surprisingly. I know in the Valley everyone has a smartphone, but business is still done through traditional phones. So if we can look at the PC1, our website widget has an identical interface. So the widget would be a part of, in this case, the insurance company's contact page. And it would pop up, again, a very similar experience. So ladies and gentlemen, in closing, I'd like to tell you a few things. If you could cue the camera on me, please. I will tell you a few things, whether the camera's on me or not. We think that this is a problem that can be solved today. And it's through a number of reasons why today is the time to solve it. The platform that we built to support that first application, Connect, though, we want to open that up to others, to CRM providers, to ERP providers, to other developers, so they too can take advantage of the API and extend the benefits of synchronizing voice and data together. Our company is called Vonada. He's Farshid, I'm Shervin, and I do not play games online. Thank you very much for your time.